For today's art activity, we are going to create a fun falling self-portrait. I'm going to start by tracing the feet at the bottom corners of my paper. On the bottom right, I'm going to trace the right side, and on the bottom left, I'm going to trace the left side of the foot. Hold the paper with your helper hand so that way it does not move as you are tracing. When you trace the hand, make sure the thumb is pointing to the middle. I'm going to have it overlap the top of the shoe just a little bit. Your hands are slightly shorter than your feet, so they should be behind your shoe. Hold those fingers still as you are tracing around them so they do not move. Use your helper hand so that way it turns out the best that it can. Take your time and work carefully, slowly, and neatly. Stop when you get to the shoe. Do not trace the line that goes across the shoe. Flip the hand over, making sure the thumb is pointing towards the middle, and trace around it again. Go carefully, slowly, and neatly. Use your helper hand again to make sure the fingers don't move while you're tracing around them. And then I'm going to stop when I get to the line for the shoe. That way it looks like the shoes are in the front and the hands are in the back. I am now going to use a roll of tape. And right here in the middle between the fingers, right here at the top, I am going to trace from one side to the other side. Not the entire thing, but just half of it. The bottom half of it for my face. So I'm going to come right down here and I'm going to put two lines for the neck, a curve for the top of my shirt, and then right here on this side, I'm going to draw a line, a diagonal line on the other side. Those will be the arms and my shoulders. From there, I'm going to come straight down to right about the same height as my top of my shoe, and I'm going to draw another straight line down. Then I'm going to connect them across for my shirt. From this corner, I'm going to go to about two-thirds up of the shoe. Not the middle, but slightly above the middle. Draw another diagonal line. Do the same on the other side. The height of this diagonal line, where it touches the shoe, is where I'm going to put a dot in the middle. From there, I'm going to draw a diagonal line to the bottom shoe, and on the other side, another diagonal line to the bottom of the shoe. Now, let's add the details for the face. I'm going to start with the nose and the mouth. Think about what expression you want to have as you are falling. Are you excited? Are you scared? Are you happy? Are you nervous? And draw that expression with the different kinds of lines and shapes you choose for your face. Now, I'm going to move on to adding more details. So let's do some hair. The type of hair that you choose to make depends on the kind of hair that you want to have in your self-portrait. I'm going to give myself some curly hair, and then I'm going to add a couple little ponytails, a couple little poofs on the side. That looks pretty cute. Again, do the hair that you want for yourself. Now let's add some extra details. I'm going to add some lines for my shirt and my pants, maybe have some pockets. I can add designs to my shirt. I can add extra details to my picture as well. Maybe on my hand, I can draw some of the lines that we see on our hand. Now remember, our hands are facing palm out. So we're not going to see our nails, but we will see the lines on the inside of our palm. So look at your hand, look at the lines, and try to draw what you see. I'm going to add some lines there. That looks pretty good. And now let's decorate the shoes. You can decorate your shoe however you want. I'm going to choose to put just some simple patterns. That looks good. And let's draw some lines and then maybe another shape at the top and another echo shape. That looks pretty good. I'm going to fill it with some stripes. You can look at the bottom of your shoe or your neighbor's shoe or think about a shoe maybe that you have at home that you like and what the bottom of it looks like. And then try to draw those designs on your shoe. Let's make some echo patterns here of the shape of the shoe and then fill it in with some stripes. Now I'm going to go back and add maybe some details for my shirt. You do not have to be in uniform, but please make sure whatever you draw is school appropriate. And I am finished, and I'm going to clean up my materials and put everything away.